Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning. God bless you. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you for sharing them. And please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be alerted when I post, when I upload a new video. God bless you. I really appreciate you. I would like to talk to you about today about tobacco and smoking cigarettes. We see it in commercials, we see people doing it every day, every day. Laws have changed. We don't smoke in offices or in stores anymore, but we used to do it in the past, we, human beings. And but what is tobacco exactly? The Holy Spirit has been talking to me about it, because there's this brother that I really love, and I'm praying for him. I would like him to stop smoking cigarettes. He's been smoking for the past 20 years. Also, and I would like him to stop. So the Holy Spirit has been giving me revelations about cigarette and its functions. Tobacco was is an American plant. When a French expedition came during the 16th century, they smoked what you know, they would have that long pipe and put tobacco and share and smoke as a welcoming you know, ritual. So you had this French doctor, his name was Dr. Nicot, who discovered nicotine, that addictive element that is in the tobacco. We cannot farm tobacco where it's called. Tobacco was not known in Europe because of the weather, obviously. And so, but they took the leaves over there. And at the same token, they took the potato from here to Europe. And you had this cook, his name was Monsieur Parmentier. He's the one who came up with that dish called hachis Parmentier. It's good. Anyway, so tobacco came from America. And when it reached the French court, people say smoking it because it was glamorous and fashionable in a pipe, or they would roll it. The idea of rolling it came, and they used to smoke. And I think if you fast forward, you see even in movies in Hollywood during the 20s, they will have that little thing, you carry the cigarette, so it's much longer, and women in the socialites will smoke, and with an attitude. But the thing is, okay, it might look glamorous, but what does it do to you in your physical body or in on your spirit? That's what I would like to address today. Tobacco is a telephone. Tobacco is a communication system from this realm of ours, of the humans, to the spiritual realm. So when you go, you look at the Indians, I mean the Native American, Columbus called them Indians, but it was wrong. They are not Indians, they are Native Americans, or the First Nation. I don't have any problem calling them that. They used to smoke cigarettes to go, to enter in communication with their ancestors, or spirit guide. And when you, for someone like me coming from Africa, I grew up, I told you, in a very traditional, typical African family, where we did ancestor worship. So I know what is witchcraft. I know what is going to a witch doctor. I know about calling spirit and summoning spirit. So I'm very mindful of things and the way it's done. But when I observed and I started learning about the Native Americans, because they are very interesting to me in so many aspects, I see that we've been listening to the same voice. We've been listening to the same gospel there, here, and we in Africa. So I'm from Central Africa. And there, when you go to a witch doctor, they will tell you the fee, like, okay, for a reading, it's, let's say, $20. And bring cash, and also bring a tobacco, a pack of cigarette, and matches, or a lighter. So when you get there, the witch doctor, they will tell you the brand, if he has a specific brand that he likes, because as you know, we have many cigarettes, many brands. And you see like a little pile of cigarette, because people come and each one of them brings a pack of cigarette. So he will take one cigarette, start smoking as we start calling the spirit. That's what we call invocation. So spirit come because of praise and worship, and they come because of the smoke, that cigarette that goes up or down to them. And then when you see in a service, in a regular church, we do what we call invocation. We praise, we worship, and we call the Holy Spirit. We invite the Holy Spirit in to come and be there for the service. So cigarette, praise and worship are a way of communicating and calling the Spirit. We see that. So to your physical body, cigarette is not good because it will make you sick. You are buying cigarette with your money, and then the finality is that you might get a serious diseases such as lung cancer or emphysema. But on the spiritual aspect of the thing is that each time that you light up a cigarette, a spirit comes, but you don't talk to him. A spirit comes, but you don't talk to him. So they start roaming around you because you keep calling, calling, calling. And they come, they come, they come. But you don't talk back to them. So they will find ways where you have an opening to come inside of you. And I can guarantee to you that when you're a smoker, the Holy Spirit is not inside of you, because who will want to live in a place that is filled with cigarettes? I personally was a smoker for 2 years. Back in the early 90s, my best friend used to smoke a pack per day, and her mom used to smoke like 2 packs per day. So she would finish one, use it to lit another one, extinguish it. So it was by being with them, by spending so much time with them in their house, I started smoking too. They used to smoke Dunhill. I didn't like that brand, the taste was too much. So I purchased more, you know, the long ones, and that's what I would smoke. So for 2 years, I was a smoker. I would smoke like 5 cigarettes per day. And then one day, I was taking my coffee. I finished my coffee and I lit up a cigarette. An idea came in my head, like, why are you smoking? It was like a frank, you know, like almost brutal way of asking. And my answer was, I don't know. Can you stop? I said, I think so. I finished that one. I extinguished it and I swore to myself that never again. So I took, I think I had a couple of packs in my drawer, and I took everything to the trash, and I've never looked back ever since. I didn't have withdrawal symptoms. I didn't have a rage, fist, or, you know, like anything like that, or shaking or sweating. So I was smoking without being an addict. Thank God I was able to stop like that, and I did, and I stopped, and no one smokes in my house. When I have guests that smoke, they go on the balcony. I don't want them to smoke inside. I cannot stand the cigarette anymore. And then now that I understand that it's a telephone, so everywhere that people smoke, spirit comes. So you can imagine what we used to do to ourselves when you go in a nightclub and you have about 20 people smoking. They will come, spirit will come, and no one is talking to them because we are busy dancing, but they are busy scouting and looking who to possess and whom they might devour. So that's what happens, that's what cigarette is. So when we look in the book, in the Bible, in the book of Revelation, Apocalypse, we see that our high priest, the Son of God, our Redeemer, is the high priest up there in heaven. So he gathers our prayers and offers them like incense to our Father. Incense is smoke. So if our prayers are taken like a smoke offered to our Father, so what does he do spiritually when we start smoking? How is God seeing the smoker when he looks down on the smoker? What does he see, and what does he do to our spiritual growth and our lives? I haven't heard a pastor talking about that. That's why I wanted to share this with you, because cigarette is not innocent. Cigarette is not something like drinking water, I'm not hurting anyone. No, there is so much more with smoking. And why is that? That when a father smokes or a mother, chances are that one of the kids, or if not all of them, are going to end up smoking too. So it becomes a spiritual thing that the father studied and he passed it on to the young, the coming generation. So we need to pay attention, we need to be mindful. And then when we see how many of our ancestors didn't smoke, because there was a time where they didn't know that smoking was harmful to your lungs and all that. And then I was researching for this video. I saw that we have 200 chemical components in the cigarette. So the cigarette that they are selling today is made more portable and more addictive compared to the tobacco, that the way it came from the ground. And my conclusion is that tobacco was not created by God, because everything that God created, it somehow goes back to Him. You can use it for the kingdom, for the glory of the kingdom, for the glory of Christ. But I haven't had any revelation of how you can use tobacco for the glory of the kingdom. So my conclusion is that tobacco was not created by God. Tobacco didn't come from God, but it came from the Nephilim, because they sinned against men, plants, and animals. So we need to be mindful of cigarettes. We need to be careful. And if we smoked, we need to repent for that. And then we need to know that since I was not there, I don't know how many of my ancestors smoked. So let's just repent about tobacco, about smoking, and let's remove the component of cigarette in our blood and our heritage, the spiritual one and the physical one, because we don't want to have the spirit of reclamation that they will come and claim back in this generation, claim back in the younger the lower one. So we need to be mindful, we need to pray and close doors, because smoking a cigarette opens doors. So we need to repent and close them. This is what I wanted to share with you, the dangers of tobacco and what it does to people. And it's not a good thing. So we need to repent and stop. Stop and go back to the drawing board and pray and repent and clean up our house. Thank you very much. God bless you.